Oh my God, we gotta go.
Heads or tails for this one?
Fine, heads.
Fine, I'll be tails then.
Every time, bro. Every time.
Every time.
Every time.
What's up, Madeira? I'm Maya.
And I'm James, and welcome to this week's episode. Hey, Maya, I've been feeling pretty down lately.
I know, me too. I think we should go to positive affirmations with chickens.
Positive affirmations with chickens. I belong here. No matter how many students ask me what my job actually is, I do work at Madeira High School. That is, I do, I really do. And you know what? It's okay if literally every person in the chess club can beat me in chess. I am trying my best. It's true. It's okay. And you know what? I don't need to be complimented about my outfit game every day. Like I wear nice clothes. I have good fits. It's all right. I believe that about myself. And I drive great in the parking lot, no matter what people think about my driving skills or my parking skills. I'm really good at both of those things. And even though I'm just the middle school musical theater director, I am important. Middle schoolers are people too.
I even know chickens worked here.
I know. I just see them in the halls sometimes.
Well, speaking of the halls, let's kick it to you in between the bells.
Hi, this is Maya with Between the Bells. Well, what sport would Gurr play in the Olympics?
Gurr, I think he'd be a big skier.
Annie, did you watch the Olympics?
Yeah, I did.
How'd you feel about Calvin Brodus' performance?
It was pretty good.
Okay. Alyssa, snowboard or snow ski?
Neither.
Leo, how do you feel about Calvin Brodus' performance in the Olympics?
I don't know who that is.
I feel like Gurr would be really good at the luge.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, or the skeleton where you go head first.
For sure. What sport would you play in the Winter Olympics?
Curling.
Would you be the pusher or the sweeper?
I'd be the sweeper.
Brooke, how do you feel about Calvin Brodus' performance in the Olympics?
You know what? Go Cal. Go Cal.
Rated on a scale of 1 to 10?
12.
I don't know anyone's names.
Sammy!
Snowboard or snow ski?
Snow ski.
I don't know. Gurr, what sport would you play in the Olympics?
Gurr?
Biathlon.
Alright. Alright, turn this off.
Now back to you in the studio. I think I'd rather ski.
I think I'd rather play basketball, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, Kyan did play some basketball in the school today. Let's go check that out.
Kyan Scott Barton never thought he'd be able to dunk again after a tragic, tragic fibula break back in the fall at a football game as he desperately tried to dunk over our principal, David Kennedy. After being in a boot for 3 weeks, Kai went into a deep depressive state. His grades were dropping. His status at school was dropping. His girlfriend dumped him. He didn't even know who he was anymore. He couldn't run, jump, shoot, anything. He didn't know what to do with himself. Until now.
How does it feel to get dunked on? Yes.
Yeah, they can come. Okay.
Yeah, I have a question for you. How does it feel to get dunked on?
Oh, it feels great.
Oh my god. Yeah. Okay, Anna, I have a question for you. Yeah. How does it feel to get dunked on?
Feels pretty good.
Oh. Sam Hurts, I have to ask you one question.
Yeah.
How does it feel to get dunked on?
Oh god.
Kyan will be known as one of the best dunkers of all time. He even got a new girlfriend. Kyan Barton will no longer be known as a failure.
Wow, some of Kyan's tricks were really cool, right? James?
Yeah?
You asleep? Okay. I think he's tired. We should probably go take a break.
No shift here. Can we get some?
You've eaten that every day this week. We can't get any more.
I love it.
Son, what do you want for dinner?
I know what I want for dinner.
The saucy, meaty taste you never outgrow.
Oh shoot, not again. Oh shoot. Oh.
What you gonna do about it?
This time, I have Frank's big time.
Get big time with Frank's big time jerk.
A couple weeks ago, Murray didn't have that much luck with Julia.
Let's catch up with him now and see if he has more luck with Jesse.
So what made you decide to pay for Murray's date?
Well, he has these cute girls, cute guys, whatever, I don't care, come over all the time, and like he's just firmly in the friend zone. And like someday I want to be a grandma, so I figure I gotta start him like doing the whole dating thing while he's in high school so he can practice, so he can find like, you know, the mother of my grandchildren.
Make sure he stops by to say hello to McDermott. Then notices we don't have our complimentary Bellinis and runs off before any of us can stop him. I'm not sure McDermott knows Elaine so well. What do you want? Why are you here?
We had a date today.
Oh, I'm sorry. I get busy sometimes, you know?
I'm sure. Well, he sits home every Friday night, all lonely and sad, looking at pictures of girls wistfully, and I just finally broke my heart that like he's in the friend zone with all these girls, and I'm like, you know, next girl that walks in here, I'm gonna give her $100 to go on a date with Murray and see how it works.
Well, what do you want?
I'm just here because you asked me here. I showed up at Dorsey and you just weren't there.
Well, reservations historically there have been very challenging to get, to say the least. But, how about some, TV?
Sure.
I got this new Apple TV Plus with the, TV feature for about $350 plus an extra $50 a month, in case you're wondering. So, don't mess with me. I figured I'd choose a section of one of my favorite movies. It's quite romantic.
Are you talking to me?
Yes!
Talking to me?
You see that? He's just like me!
Possessions. I should get one of those signs that says one of these days I'm gonna get organized.
You mean organized?
Organized. Organized. It's a joke. O-R-G-A-N-E-Z-I-E-Z-D.
Hey! You wanna meet my dad?
He said that he left to get cigarettes a few years ago, but he hasn't come back since, but I think he'll come back a few days from now. But this is a... Oh, you have a call. Is it your friend? No, listen, can I say hi to your friend, please? That'd be great.
Hi.
That'd be great.
I'm at 7360.
Is your friend gonna come by too? I think it's just best if we stick it, you know, if it's just ourselves here, you know? Come, here, let me talk to your friend real quick. Let me talk to your friend!
I'm really sorry. I have to go. My friend who's in Ireland really needs me. I'll call you, right?
I'll call you.
Unfortunately, Murray didn't do very well with his dating.
But I heard some of our winter sports teams have. In fact, swimming was at state this past week.
Oh yeah, that's really cool. Let's go check out some more sports with Izzy.
This is Izzy with sports. Congrats to our wrestlers for placing second at this weekend's CHL tournament, and special shout out to Nate Opichka and Gus Kaiser for placing first in their weight class. Congratulations to our swimmers who competed in districts this past weekend, and congrats to the 8 swimmers who qualified for state. We wish them the best of luck. Our boys basketball team won their first tournament game on Tuesday night and are moving on to play CHCA at Princeton High School tonight. Make sure to come out and support the Stangs. Back to you in the studio.
James, I heard your baseball season's coming up.
Yeah, it is, but I've been focusing more on the esports side of things.
Oh, cool. Let's go hear more about that.
Oh my god!
Oh!
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 That was the luckiest goal of your life.
Oh dear. Oh. Oh my.
Oh my god.
This about to be freer than a...
What did you kind of funny? Can you just shut one? Up? So we can you shut up so we can actually get the game started?
Zach, stop.
Oh, instantly destroyed.
Let's go.
My man.
I said about to be freer than a public park.
Not like you're going to any of those with any girls.
How did we do that?
Oh my god.
I'm pretty sure there is some rule against being overly toxic.
Yeah, we should report there and just win the match because they're toxic.
I've never even heard of the names of most of those video games.
Yeah, but I heard H knows a lot about our teachers' names. Let's kick it to him with this week's challenge.
All right, welcome back to First Name Basis with H. I'm H, and follow me as we talk to one of my very favorite close friends and teacher. Let's take a look. So, Brett, how are you doing?
Did you just call me Brett?
I mean, we are friends, right? Yeah, like we're good friends.
Of course.
So, do you know my middle name?
Hi.
That was clever. Amanda, can we interview you?
For what?
Because you're my friend and we're on a first name basis, so like, you know.
Oh, yeah, that's right, we are.
Yeah, so you know my first name, I know your first name, which, that's cool.
Okay, what are you going to ask me?
No, no, that's my first name. Well, it's Amanda.
Yeah. Yeah, my first name's Amanda. Thanks,
yeah,
H.
Mine's H. Excuse me. Margaret, just wanted you to know you're appreciated. You're a good teacher.
Very kind of you to come and tell me that. Thank you.
Absolutely. Hello, Dan. So what's your mantra, your style to life? What would you give What's Up Madeira for some advice?
I'm not interested in the impromptu.
You didn't like this?
No, I don't like this at all. If you would give me time, I could come up with something creative, but...
All right, write a script, we'll be back. Okay. Hey, John. Just a quick question about a math problem.
I've never even called Gurr anything other than Gurr.
Yeah, who knew his name was actually John?
I didn't. I've learned so many new things this episode.
Well, that wraps it up for this week's great edition.
Make sure you like and subscribe and follow us on Instagram.
And until next time, I'm James.
And I'm Maya.
What's up, Madeira? What's up, Madeira?